When Ramaphosa decided that he was going to work with ETA, what was he thinking, right? Somebody says it is the same Helen Zille who was once described as African, who was once described as Africans as refugees in their own country, right? Oh, let me say, somebody once said, somebody says it is the same Helen Zille who once described Africans as refugees in their country. This form of racial attitude is what the ANC is signing up for. It is, look, it says more about the ANC than about Zille or the DA. Yeah, I would have said it better. A lot of people are very angry with the relationship between Ramaphosa. When they say that it says more about the ANC but than Ramaphosa, than DA, I specifically say it says more about Ramaphosa than anybody else. The fact that he feels comfortable working with such people, it says a lot about Ramaphosa. Like I'm telling you guys, it says a lot about Ramaphosa for the fact that he feels very comfortable working with people who think that colonialism was actually a good thing for local that ever happened in this country. Though they were forced to apologize, but the fact remained that what they said, it comes from the heart. They speak from the heart. So if people share such sentiment, and when you feel comfortable working with them, what do you expect, right? I would be glad. You know, the day they turn against Ramaphosa, the day they decide that they're going to turn against him, I will be glad. I will not feel any pity for him, right? Seeing him there, you know what I'm saying, in custody, Akhawulisa. Personally, I will not feel any pity for him the day they turn against him, because that day is coming where they shall turn against him. Look, against Ramaphosa. There was an article released by IOL, written by Usipho Sepe, right? It says, GNU talks exposes the omnipotency of white supremacy. Oh, did you hear that? And then it says, the unseemingly spat between the African National Congress, ANC, President Ramaphosa, the leader of the Democratic Alliance, DA, comes as no surprise. Why are you saying it comes as no surprise? Because Ramaphosa is a black man. He understands the struggle of a black person. You know what I'm saying? I know you're about to find more in this article. It says, this partly has to do with the fact that they represent different agendas. What responds to opposite interest, right? So we are about to get into this journey and this endeavor. But before we do so, I would like you to do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, so let me take you through this, right? Let me take you through this. The DA has once doubled as a party of white bosses and black stooges, is seen as fundamentally opposed to the aspiration of the majority who remain landless in the country of their forefathers or forebears. For the DA, a government of national unity made up of black parties will be an anathema. And it's arrogancy. The DA describes such possibility as a doomsday eventuality. Right there, it is. You see, Usipola wrote a very interesting thing, right? That a lot of people are not picking up now, but on the later stage, when people shall, where people shall be awakened to themselves, at some such articles will be remembered. Unfortunately, it will be too late because probably the damage would have been caused by then. You can't trust Helen Zille. You can't do yourself that mistake. You cannot trust that woman. That woman, no. That woman is bad news. I'm telling you guys, that woman is bad news. This historic fact has not deferred the ANC of Ramaphosa, who has made a first-hand deal with Democratic Alliance. In doing so, it has chosen to trade its soul and mission of advancing the total emancipation of African people from socio-economic local bondage. Such pacts are unstoppable. The exchange of letters between the ANC and the DA reveals as such. For his party, Ramaphosa was quick to remind the leader of DA, Johnston Hazen, that the ANC found the letter of the DA federal chairperson to be offensive, condescending, and inconsistent with the constitution. The question is, if that's the case, somebody's calling me, guys. I need to tell this person that, yay, I'm recording. I'm gonna call you back, right? Yeah. So listen to this one. Yeah. Ramaphosa had to remind EDA that you are violating the constitution, but the DA said or claimed that they are there to protect the constitution. The question is, how do you protect the constitution when you yourself are violating the constitution already in the beginning? When you are found wanting, how do you then claim that when you will protect the constitution? So, in other words, I agree with what is written here, right? He says, when as he continues writing, the condescending and the disdain method to Ramaphosa, local president Ramaphosa and the ANC from the DA leadership is commonplace. It is about putting black person in his place. No black person is immune from such treatment. No exalted space or borrowed robes can protect one. In other words, when you put the DA and the ANC in one place, you are bound to have a situation where all the other this statement is deep. In other words, the decision that was made by Ramaphosa, it affects more black people than you can think, right? More black people will be treated badly by DA because of Ramaphosa bringing DA here. And we've already seen this thing from DA, that they think they are there to supervise black people. That's the rotten mentality that they have. We have already seen that, and we don't need to be reminded of that. But nevertheless, he even said, as a president of the most powerful nation on earth, former U.S. President Barack Obama could be asked to fetch a coffee at a black tie dinner and mistaken for a velvet. In his own words, Obama had this to say: "There is no black male my age who is a professional who hasn't come out of a restaurant and is waiting for their car, and somebody didn't hand them their car keys." Huh. Okay, what does it mean? Beyond driving a hard bargain, Zille has been consistent in her views. What did Ramaphosa expect from someone forced to apologize for having tweeted? For those claiming the legacy of colonialization was only negative, think of your independent judicial, transport infrastructure, piped water. And, you know, when you say that, it makes me think, Uguti, where are we going with this thing, right? Where? To which extent are we going to go with this thing? Like, it's quite important and it's quite funny that we have to go, we are dealing with this type of Ramaphosa right now. I mean, we are dealing with this Ramaphosa who feels comfortable to working with the enemy. It's just just weird. Nah, it's just weird. But yeah, former President Nelson Mandela was unequivocally on such matter. We were placed in a position in which we had either to accept a permanent state of inferiority or defy the government. The lack of human dignity experienced by Africans is a direct result of policy of white supremacy. White supremacy implies black inferiority. Oh, I like this explanation, because you can easily get loose when you talk about it. Now that he explains that, it's so powerful when he says that the moment you say white supremacy, automatically you are saying black are inferior, right? So why do you bring a person who possesses such attribute that says white are supreme, right, who promotes white supremacy, and you still bring such a person in government? Really doesn't make sense. That's why I said Ramaphosa is white inside and black outside. I'm telling you, one day you'll remember that. He continues to say, deep inside, an anger mount of accumulating insult, but he vents in his wrong direction on a fellow man in the township on a property of a black person. That is very interesting, right? Because you don't vent your anger towards the right people who have angered you. This is the same thing we always say when you are protesting against the government. Why bend the things that are important to you? It's very important. I get it. By the way, my elder mom, whatever that is. She lost her car. There was a protest somewhere. She was going back home, somewhere in Katlehong, right? So, because there was a protest, her car was banned or it bumped into stones because of that protest. I just don't forget, but it's something that happened 3 years ago. Here, because of protest, right? So it's people venting out their anger, destroying someone's property, but that person is not the one who angered them. This is very important, what is being said here. Rob Hesov, who has become an infamous for his acerbic remarks, describes self-hate as follows. The mutual hatred that all ANC and former ANC guys have for each other surpasses any supposed enmity they claim to have towards us white people. That was always a guarantee that they will never work together. Hey, this statement is very deep, guys. This statement is very deep. Yo, I'm not gonna go down and read this article. This is a very detailed article. This is very, very, very detailed article. But yeah, in conclusion, I will say, for Ramaphosa to feel very comfortable working with the DA, It's something that must be studied. I'm telling you. It's something that needs a considerable amount of study. For him to feel very comfortable around DA says a lot about the man. It says a lot about the man. There's something that we don't know about Ramaphosa that other people know. Maybe they are scared to tell us, yeah, but fwet. I don't know. Probably. What do you think? Why is Ramaphosa very keen to work with people who believe that they are superior than him? Like, I wouldn't even think of it. Personally, I wouldn't even consider working with a person who thinks that they are superior than me. Even, look, just to be in a relationship with a woman who thinks that she's superior than me, and now I'm as, you know what I'm saying? I'll be like, nope. Relationship are for partnership, not this thing of you thinking that you are coming to boss me here. No. Relationship is for partnership. I'm just giving an example. I wouldn't even consider it.
So why would Ramaphosa consider going in bed with a person who thinks that, who believes in white supremacy? Hey, hey, hey. TikTok.